Lola friend. Sorry, it's a little bit of a misstep there. Dapper Drab here. And we are going to be defending our title against PK Light today. So, you know, you've seen the deck list. It's going to be down in the description. I know what I'm facing because he posted his, but we'll just find out what he's facing in a second. But right now, I'm going to go ahead and throw the unit. Sorry if that was super loud. I'm sure it was. I should probably lower that occasionally, actually. And I'm actually hoping that the sound, the background noise for the background music for the Pokemon Trading Card Game is playing. But we'll see. So of course our deck is a Duskmane Necrozma. This is the one I am looking at for tournament play. I really like this deck a lot. Gone over it a couple times now, so I'm sure you guys know what it is, and we are defending our title today. So we're gonna be taking on PK Light, and I think he might have brought something that I'm allergic to, so we'll see how well we do. Let's make sure I get the right deck. Dust, Tempest, Trash. Is it Dust, Tempest, Trash? No, it's Tempest, Trash, PTCGO, PokeTuber Battle League. That's what it is. Just want to make sure I got the right one. Come on, I just opened it, right? Where are you? I have too many decks. I need to get rid of some. Yes, I'm basing a list off of Towards for Fossils. Alolan Buzzhulk. It's not that, is it? I don't know which one it is that he's... this one, it is not that one. That's Dusk, Tempest, Trash. No, it's not that one. It's gotta be down further then, because it's Tempest, Trash. Alright, I'm having a super hard time finding my decks. This is embarrassing. I should know exactly what my decks are, right? There it is. I somehow passed it. Must be because I'm like in it. So it's this one, Tempest Trash, so we're going to go ahead and challenge PK, as he asked us to, even though he's the challenger, he's supposed to challenge me, right? No, but we got challenged by Professor Red when we were facing him too, so it's fine. So, we are facing PK Light, this nice little jacket, a fighting psychic water, you guys can guess what it is, but most people are going to know what that is, fighting psychic water, Buzzhole. It is Buzzhole, which... I was wondering if I have the advantage or not. I mean, this deck is huge in format, so... Are you kidding me? Ugh, a Lele start. I don't even like to use my Lele in this deck. We got a Lele start. Yikes, yikes. We're going first, right? Yeah, we're going first. So, I have options. I have options because we can, we have those two max elixirs. We can kind of get set up really fast here. But we are banking, and I do mean banking on a, yes, please, Mulligan. Yes, I'm okay with getting the Prism Star out right away. We got Buzzhole right there. We got a draw supporter too, so that's really exciting. So let's see what we can do. We are definitely going to Ultra Space first. We want to pull out something that's going to hit here. The question is to rely on the three max elixirs or not. I think I kind of want Celesteela here over the Duskmane. Three energies. I think Celesteela is my play. It doesn't quite hit enough though. No, I already have. I already have the Solgaleo. So let's grab the Duskmane himself. Gotta watch out for that baby buzz, but we should be fine. It's max elixir. Whiff. Max elixir. Okay, we hit that one. That's good. Throw it on. Toss down another tree. And I think we're gonna ultra ball here. No, we don't want to ultra ball here. We're gonna go ahead and Cynthia. I like Cynthia right now, so we're gonna do that. We did not get the Trubbish though. It's a little question. We can attack next turn. So I think we let him hit into Tapu Lele, and then we're gonna retreat Tapu Lele. Seems like the best option, but we will find out right now. Let's go ahead and give it over to PK Light. So I'm hoping that, yes, okay, good. So the audio levels look okay. I'm always a little worried about that. I'm known for having some audio issues occasionally, so just making sure that everything is playing at the right volume and there's not like bad sound. I'm not a professional at this yet. I do say yet because I'm loving these kind of videos. I'm loving these tournaments, and you guys might see more. Recently, also another tournament I was able to get myself into by paying attention. There's a lot of there's just some streamers winning in team that got the tournament together, and I was able to squeak my way in to be able to get into that 128 person tournament. I thought about bringing this, but I might have to make some adjustments to it, because this deck right here I'm facing is probably going to be a big boy in that tournament. So this is kind of the initial test, I guess, to see, you know, how does this my deck face off against what I'm facing right now. So he does get the Jet Punch Force. Bench. 70, sorry, I forgot about the Reggie. We get the Celesteela, so we're pulling all of our Ultra Beast and none of our guys. Huh. I need another, like, Elixir. So we'll throw this here. I like Celesteela on the board. We'll throw a Float on Lele. And he has 5 cards, so we're just gonna Cynthia. We're not exactly getting the cards we want. Get a Fighting Fury, but we get that trouble. That trouble right there. We could use our Ultra Beast here. I mean, we could use our Ultra Space here to grab a Duskmane Necrozma. I mean, that's the ultimate question here. Ooh, I could Blade GX. That might be an option. Yeah, let's Blade GX. That way I don't have to use the Ultra Space. We can get rid of this Beast Energy right here. We can retreat into Kartana. Multi-switch a Metal Energy up there. Who should I put the Fighting Fury Belt on? I don't need it yet. Don't need it yet. Yet is the keyword there. But he's going to be hitting numbers pretty soon. But I can definitely take a prize here. And we definitely want the Ultra Ball for next turn. I feel like I want to hold on to it for now because I'm not using it for damage modifying or raising my HP. But we're going to go ahead and Blade GX here. Could be a mistake. Dusk Shotting would be my only option. And we get a Cyrus. That's a... I really want to play that. So they are going after the main guy right now, Dusk Necrozma. That's kind of my goal with this deck. He's going to try for the one shot, okay. That's something he might not have tried if I would have put the Fighting Fury Belt down. But this is fine, it gets 2 energies in the discard. He did not get the knockout. That's important to note. So we get the Garbodor. That's nice that we get the Garbodor. I could Cyrus. He would be down to 2 Benchmons, but I like to pair that with a knockout. And I don't think we can pair that with a knockout right now. What we need is a draw supporter. And he only has 40 HP left anyways. We can make it 80. wall supporter. I only have Cyrus. Oh, that sucks. Let's go ahead and grab the Dusk main. What am I needing right now, though? I almost need that double colorless energy. Or two more metals. I might need, like... Alright, I think it's let this go down and try to get those beast rings. That's probably my best option. Now I'm feeling like I shouldn't have multi-switched there, because now he can't attack. I could do some 60 damage to him right now. I'm really stuck. And he can just sledgehammer for the knockout on this next turn. Everything's a basic, so Cyrus isn't super useful right now. I choose two bench Pokemon and keep those and get rid of the rest. It's just not quite the card I want to play yet. I think I want to wait till he beast energies and then play Cyrus. So I'm a little bit stuck here, actually. Nothing I can do right now. Yeah, because I didn't draw that energy, I can't even attack. Yikes. That's a really, really bad turn for me. Super bad turn for me. He might be able to go off on this turn now. But luckily I think that Buzzhole's Sling Around will not work because I did Blade GX. So like, that's a plus-sided Blade, I guess, is that because I Blade GX'd, he knocks out Dustman, I'm gonna be down to 3. So he can still Beast Ring. No, he can't Beast Ring because he hasn't. Like, he can still Beast Ring. But he can't, you know, use Sledgehammer. And so we did get that. How much do I trust that to come out, right? Okay, we got a free retreat here. Top of the- I don't know what I'm thinking. I'm like, what do I put up? Oh, that's right, Tapu Lele has free retreat. That's right. So this looks like a turn for Radiant. Yeah, this looks like a Radiant star turn to me. And I feel like I want to make it 200 for him to be able to knock that out. Now the question here is for draw supporter or not. I think I'm gonna have to go for the draw supporter. Sorry, Dusk main. This is really the only reason to play Lele in this deck. Is this right here. We wanna get that float for his damage down here. So we might actually wanna grab an N. Since we have that as well. We don't wanna throw away the Cyrus. It's too useful later on. We definitely want to lower his hand size too. So I think I'm going to deal with 5 cards. Because it's 5 or 6, I mean that extra card could be useful. But it might not be necessary. Okay, here we go. We did get a beast ring. That is something. That is something for sure. We'll throw it on the Celesteela, I guess. Well, let's see. We can Gale, go back into the deck. Or we can Celesteela. I already attached the energy to Solgaleo, though. We're gonna Celesteela. We have that beast energy for next turn. Float stone. We got another. No, we didn't get another float stone. We got the float stone. Or the Garbolock. That's what we wanted. Something we can Ultra Space for. We did miss, we did whiff a Beast Ring, but we only play 2, so it's kind of only expected to be able to hit 1 anyways. At least we did hit 1. Now it looks like it's time to Radiant Star and get another hit out on us. Fortunately, we only have 2 metal in the discard. I think I'm gonna split that so I can attack with either one of them. There we go, so we got our energy back. He's gonna have to hit us for a whopping 200 damage to knock out the Solgaleo. And with that ability lock, Garbodor, he's gonna have gonna need a field blower to take out the other block to have access to that extra 30 damage. But I mean, the strong energy still works. So we'll see. I mean, like, is it time? Do we need to flip the hat around and get serious about this game with PK Light? We might have to here. Prizes are 4-5. It's been a long game. 100 damage. We can Cyrus now. Still not the best option. And I gotta figure out a way to retreat Solgaleo too. I didn't think that through. Yeah, because we can't Ultra Ball for Guzma. Not with our two Lele's out. This is where I kind of like Ninja Boy, so we can put Lele's back into the pile when we need to. Still feel like... What would he get rid of? He'd get rid of his two supporters and the Baby Buzz. I guess I need to wait till he gets a Beast Ring off or something before I use that. And I don't want to put my Beast Energy down until I'm sure he doesn't have any enhanced hammers or anything. That sucks, because, yeah, he's stuck. He's stuck in the active. I have nothing there. Might have to throw away the Cyrus here. Unfortunately, that seems like the play. I gotta get aggressive. Oh, I can Beast Ring again. I can Max Elixir again. Got the Guzma for next turn. Beast Ring is what's gonna go on the Kartana. Don't want a Beast Ring on the Kartana. I still have an access to the Beast Ring next turn anyways. So we're gonna Max Elixir and whiff it! Whiff it. Oh, come on. I want to put that double colorless on the Lele. That's what I want to do. So we have a Metal Energy here for next turn. Have Cortana. I could throw some Metal Energy. Throw it onto the top of Lele. I don't like that idea though. I don't like that idea at all. Ugh, why do you have to be stuck, Solgaleo? I had to give you that extra HP though, so you could survive. There's no way here. Sorry, I'm stalling. I'm not stalling on purpose. How many medals do I have left in the deck anyways? I have two medals, so that Beast Ring will still be in effect next turn, and I could try to find an Ultra Beast, but I don't have one. They're all in here. Rescue Stretcher is really all I could get. I might as well throw this on, but I don't want to throw away any of these cards. What's my play here? Just a Radiant Star and stall? Yeah, there's no energy. I could have threw one away, but there's not really a point. This is not functioning like it does normally for me. Ooh, an N to 5 cards. I think he only gets like 4, yeah. Metal. Just energy. So we get the double colorless energy though. I think Celesteela here can kind of just come in and clean up though. We will have to watch out for Big Bad Buzzy Boy, but okay, so Garp has the free retreat. We're going to use him as a pivot. So I decide exactly what I'm doing here. We get a float, nice. I don't want to throw that away though. Sick more. DC 20, 40, 60. Yeah, it's not enough if I throw a DC on the Lele to knock out the Baby Buzz. And this guy is the one to be scared of, really. We have the abilities blocked, so they are hitting for less damage, but he is still hitting for 180. so he's still hitting for 180. That is something to be worried about. I can't justify Sycamore in here. There's nothing I really need in here except those three Guzmas that are just chilling in the deck for no reason. Don't have any boosters, so 70 damage is all I'm gonna hit with Kartana, which is a two shot on this, and I can't keep it like that. We're gonna retreat into Celestia, and I think we throw a DCE on a Lele for backup attack. That seems to be where I'm at right now, and I don't think he can hit this 200 too easily. So we're just going to Moon Press for the one shot here. I don't think the other one does more damage. Yeah, it does not do more damage. So we're going to Moon Press. KO. Yeah, I was like, wait, if Buzz Hole was there, we need right there, that rest wasn't in the deck. It was in the prizes. We had to take out Baby Buzzy Boy to be able to, Baby Buzz Holdia to get that rescue stretcher. And how are we doing now? I feel like we're in a way better spot. It's a matter of, can he get another strong energy on Buzz Hole? I feel like that's his choice, because Celesteela is a monster. He might need the... I need that other Fighting Fury belt to make it just impossible to overcome Celesteela. But other than that, this is a super close game. Like, okay, so I will have to figure out this deck a little bit. It struggles with this three count Baby Buzz deck. I mean, Celesteela is a good option, you know, as a fighting resistance. It hits for that perfect 130 attack or HP on the Baby Buzz. But if they play Fighting Fury Belts, like, I assume somebody might. Hitting 170 with Celesteela is more difficult. Like, it's not very possible. So he brings up the big boy. Oh, he does have it. Choice. Resistance saved me. Oh, man. Whew. Resistance just saved me. So there's no reason not to shuffle three in here. It's still my stadium up here, so I can choose whichever one I want. Resistance just saved Celesteela so much. Wow. Just wow. That's amazing. The problem is I think these are my last two metal energies. We'll double check that right now as we're grabbing our Duskmane. Okay, we have one more metal energy, which means we have one more Duskmane mains attack. Which is, I'd have to commit every energy I have to Duskmane, though. Oh, an option. Okay, so an option I do have is, Kartana. I have an option to Kartana and put those three energies back in there in order to set up a Duskmane. That might be a better option here. Although if they take two more prizes, this guy is going to be a bigger attacker. Yeah, this guy's going to be a bigger attacker if they take two more prizes. So I feel like it's best to just load him up. I'm going to do this because I know he can cleanly take out this next KO. Yeah. He can cleanly take out this next KO, or Kartana can, with just the energies they have on them. So I'm going to let them take Celesteela and trust that they cannot come back at it. Although I will say that four prizes... Gotta watch out for that sledgehammer. Uh, Although I won't have food. Yeah, okay, okay. So I should be fine. This deck is giving me issues, though. We're going to get for that 160 damage here. Because we can. So hold on, one sec. Do we need something different here? Do we want to throw down the floats and dig? That's the question here. Do we want to throw down the floats and dig for more numbers? Because we can hit 160, 170 here, maybe? Oh, if we had a choice band. I don't think we play choice bands. But if we played choice band, we would have had this knockout. But I don't think we do. And I'm probably running out of time, actually. See, I'm scared to, like, throw the floats on these guys because they don't really need them. We already attached, though, so that's the question. Throw in Little Duskmane. I want to get damage on this thing, though, as much as physically possible. I have one more Fighting Fury belt. I think it's in the prizes, though. I'm, like, one energy out there. I think Celesteela just has to hit big here, and then I keep these float stones in case they get rid of these. I don't want to commit. Do not want to commit both. I think it's just hit for some numbers. You know that either one is going to be able to come in for the next turn. So it's like that resistance saving Celesteela was huge. Was huge. It's 160 damage worth. I know, factually, do not play choice bands. Maybe right there, that is a reason to play one, because with the beast energy, with the three energy, Celesteela can hit that number. But wow. Whew. Wow. He's digging. I didn't feel comfortable throwing the two floats down. I feel like a field blower is coming. Beast ringing turn. Now's the time to get Cyrus. I'll play a top deck Cyrus. And we can just go to town. Yeah, so he's got the next buzz hole set up. He's ready to take this game. He's like, oh, there's my target right there. Celesteela, Tapu Lele, or Cartana. I can take out anybody. That's what he's saying right now. He's preventing me from getting my Duskmane Necrozma. He knows I have it back in the deck because I rescue stretchered. He's going to super rod himself, get some energies back, probably. Yep. So we can max Elixir again. He must have one. And right now he has two attackers that are monsters. But I definitely want to Cyrus because he does have it set up next for his Lycanroc to come out and take that last KO as well. This sucks. I'm in a pickle. I'm in a super pickle because not enough HP. Neither one of them have enough HP. They're the ones that have the energy on them. And I need to attack with him for Dusk Shot. So he's okay, so he's more worried about that. Interesting to note. Lele has a free retreat. Sit on her, lay on her for a second. They have one prize. This guy is a monster now. If I could hit the last max elixir, which I do have, by the way. I could do that, but that other one would just come in and knock it out. Or is that my only play? That's my only play, isn't it? That looks like my only play is to throw this here, float some stuff. I need the Fury Belt. Float him. Don't need that. Float. Who to float? Her? And the Sycamore? Did I seriously not hit the max elixir? I know it exists. Got the energy here anyways. So that's unfortunate. I just lost this. Digging for that max elixir. I just lost this. Because I can knock out this guy. Like, my only option was to max elixir, get rusty claws to be able to take out this guy, and then he would not be able to hit hard with Buzzhole. He'd be able to hit hard with this Buzzhole GX, but not hard enough. So that's gonna be the game. As a consolation, I can take out this guy, but this one is just impossible. That Beast Ring, I left myself at 4 prizes for far too long. When you have the whole, like, 4 turns to hit the Beast Ring, like, it's guaranteed. So it is what it is. Duskmane, that's really all I have. Duck Shot on the bench. I'll be a PK well played. And PK is the new king. I will forfeit my throne to the new king, PK Light, guys. So, good job. I hope your reign goes long. Thank you guys so much for stopping by. If you guys are interested in what he was playing, it's a Buzzhole list, guys. It's the Buzzhole list. The 1-1 Lycanroc, 1-1 Octillery, 1 Regirock, 1 Lele, 2 Buzzhole GXs, and 3 baby Buzzholios. So that is the list, guys. He was able to just blast me with those Beast Rings. I gave him 4 turns. 4 turns. Why did I give him 4 turns of that stuff? Man, that was just bad for me. But, again, congratulations to PK Light. Well deserved. He did work for it. Like, I really think if I would've got that max elixir, taken out that main Buzzhole, I would have stood a chance to still win. But you guys can let me know in the comment section if I am false, if I'm wrong. But let me also know how you guys are enjoying the PokeTuber Battle League. It'll be a little bit before I am up again. It looks like PK has to face off against his first rival of Professor Red and Electric Husky again first. So thank you guys so much for stopping by. This has been Dapper Drabby. And I'll bid you guys alola, and I hope to see you on another video. Bye-bye.